Dominic is een Maastricht-based collective of visual artist Mike Mone, goldsmith Don Posse en sound composer Nika Schmidt. They operate in grey areas that can be found in between fashion, art, clothing and sculpture, concept and material, quality and value, streetwear and couture. To connect their individual practices, they use elements of pre-owned clothes and fabrics.
We started this a couple of years ago that we were selling second-hand clothes, and we thought it would be nice to hack clothes in the sense that we buy second-hand prints and images and paste them onto existing clothing and give them not just a new life but also a new style and also a new statement about the clothes that you're wearing.
Do you experience any differences working on ready-to-wear pieces instead of working in a more autonomous way?
But there are some pieces of ours that are more sculptural that you just could put in your room, maybe.
Which one would you?
Yeah, maybe those shoes or these shoes. They will be like, if you will be walking on potato chips all day long if you wear these, because it's a small a sculptural approach. You can hear it, but for us it doesn't make any. This one too. This one is finished. It's dope as hell. And we don't have a price on it because it just makes sense to us. But you could wear it, but you probably wouldn't because it could come off. But you could also hang it on your wall or just hang it in your store or in your car for air freshening. I don't know. You could put it anywhere. It doesn't make a difference for us. It's all about the approach and I think also about the attitude towards it. That's also why we can have pieces like this. With it could be a cool jacket, but you cannot close it. Yeah, is that why you maybe do not want to have it? No, you just want to wear Jesus on your back.
I like to use the word hacking. In that sense, that you take clothing, existing designs, because there's so much going on in fashion and in designs existing. Of course, it is from an existing brand, an existing design, but I add something to it that it becomes unique and my own. I think that is my vision.
And sometimes it's more thought about than other pieces. This is the dishwash inception piece, which has all the different towels coming together.
Then we kept on going, and then it became like every piece kind of tells a story. Like this piece is clearly a towel of a palm tree, and at the same time it has the inside of a rain jacket, and it makes, for me, it's like the flair that I'm putting onto this piece is a tent on the beach.
And this is more of a cut-up, which has someone looking out your pocket. But it's also part of the piece. This is really like a more destroyed piece, but still, it's like super styling. This one too. Couldn't see, this is the back. It's like pretty normal, but then on the front it's like bang. This malkmeisje all washed up, and you have the thing around the neck. So sometimes also the shoes, they are sticky as hell with the glitter, and this is also just like with the, how's it called? Hot glue. I just glue them together. But this is more this piece would be more of the kind that you put in your shoe rack, and then when you have visitors, you tell them it's a piece of art that's in your shoe rack. Kind of that vibe is also not forbidden.
We have to see how it continues in that sense. Like, are we going more into the direction of only wearable fashion, or even the other way? That it's only going to be sculpture and artworks themselves.
And it's the place where we meet. It's this. I don't think there's a way we can go too far. But maybe the others do. Maybe this goes too far. Bible cafe. I don't know. Depends on your own emotions, not mine. Come on.
Yeah,
what's that? Yeah, dang it. Oh, oi, oi. Knip het maar eruit allemaal. Moet even plassen.
Talent Lab is a talent development project initiated by Toneelgroep Maastricht and VIA Zuid. In the fourth edition of Talent Lab, young promising professional talents from the performing arts work intensively together for a month to further develop their artistry. Fashion and costume designer Carlijn Veuring, who participated twice before in Fashion Clash Festival, is one of the participants of this edition of Talent Lab.
I'm Carlijn Veuring. I'm a fashion and costume designer. Before I was a product designer and then I slowly got more into costumes, and now I also do more wearable fashion as well. During my studies I already always kind of worked around the body and with movement. Well, since they knew that it was going to be a collaboration also with Fashion Clash, they asked Branko if he got a few people that he thought would be a right fit for this project, and then he asked me. I made two collections. Both were shown during Fashion Clash, like 2 years after each other. That was really nice. Yeah, it was like the first really fashion event as well. So I got like, the first time I had to deal with models, but it was so nice. It was such a really great experience because all the models were also very excited to work with the costume, because I asked them like, yeah, also have to dance a bit, like have to like figure out what the costume does when you move. They did it really well, and the audience and also the festival itself was also really like a nice place to experiment something different. With theater, it's something completely new, but I'm always trying to work with people from different disciplines. But this is really new, and it's so inspiring to see how they like start a new project. I think I'm the only one that kind of starts from a material, because I always start with like a construction or the way a material behaves. And I think the others also got inspired by that, and so we started also working in the workshop with just material, and that's the starting point. I don't think we started like, okay, this time fashion is very important and we have to incorporate that. We just started seeing what everybody's talents were, and we're like, okay, I want to do this with you because this is something you do is so interesting to me. And after that, slowly it became more clear that we always did something with identity and with the body and with kind of the relation with a body and with something else. And I think that is also what's in fashion, really the relation between the body and something else. So it became more natural. I don't think I had like a teaching role or, yeah.
Toneelgroep Maastricht has, as one of the major theater companies in Holland, has the task to develop a new performance talent. So let's try to focus on development of talent instead of presenting talent. Yeah. Fashion is movement, fashion is music. And you think in rhythm and color and movement and sound and image, then a whole world opens up. And in this world, they can relate in duos and trios to come to experiments which they never could have thought of. And that's very rewarding, because as long as they stay out of the focus on the presentation, it's inspiring to work with each other. Especially for theater people, for colleagues, who come and watch, very strange that the result looks not finished, seemingly unprepared. But that is because we've only focused on the process. Because in the process, people can develop themselves and their skills, not on doing a final exam. So we try to ask them to stay out of the feeling that they are going to do an exam. So what I learned from Branko and from fashion is to look even better to things and to how people present themselves. And how and that clothes always tell a story about people. Even my clothes tell a story about me. And it's very nice to become aware of that.
Flores, and I'm a fashion designer. As a fashion designer, I always get inspired by workwear, and it's actually because I focus on sustainability in fashion. For me, it's really important that my garments are durable, so you can use it. You can use them for a long time. They are functional, and you have a lot of freedom of movement. I also like to concentrate on timelessness. That's also something I see back I recognize in workwear. So this is actually my main inspiration. And for this collection, I was inspired by my grandfather. He was a shoemaker and. When I was younger, I always visited this workshop, and I can still remember the smell of glue mixed with leather, and I don't know, this is just a really precious memory for me, and I just wanted to make an ode or a tribute to my grandfather, and so with the workwear in mind, and then. Taking my grandfather as an inspiration, I came up with this collection. So the collection is really inspired on workwear and my grandfather, and then focusing on the timelessness and the durability and the freedom of movement. To tell the story about my grandfather and also about my grandmother, because I think they were really like a really strong couple, and with this film I wanted to show that, maybe make an ode to the both of them, and so.
Thank you.